Hello everyone, hope you are doing well. I am your instructor Akshay Pamar, assistant professor at LJ Institute of Engineering and Technology in IT ICT department. Welcome back to the video tutorial series of the Internet of Things, right? In this today's session, we are going to discuss about really interesting Internet of Things application, right? And that is military of things, right? So it is really different, that is really different compared to the our civilians Internet of Things, right? And with that, we are going to discuss about voice apps on the Internet of Things devices, right? So let's in this today's session, we are going to discuss about military of things, IoMT, you are aware about, right? After that, we will see the home automation with the help of the IoT, and at the end, we are going to discuss about voice apps on the IoT devices, right? So let's begin with the military things, right? The IoMT, right? The military, the Internet of Military Things is an application of an Internet of Things technology and the concepts to the military domain, right? So remember that things, right? Remember that things. The IoT technologies and the concepts for the military domain is called an Internet of Military of Things, right? The military IoT adoption is still in its infancy, right? It's still in its infancy. However, defense companies and the armed forces are eager to prepare, understand, and leverage the IoT, right? There are clear military benefits from the use of the IoT devices for the armed forces, ranging from vehicle maintenance to the personal monitoring to the stock control, right? So at that time, with the lesser human interaction, you can keep an eye on all of that things, right? In today's scenario, the military commander may have been several minutes to be prepared with an assessment of a situation in way quickly assimilated to assess the potential course of an action and make that decision, right? It needs to draw upon all the possible sources to ensure that the most complete and the relevant picture can be created of the situation, right? And the implication of the different decision understood, right? However, integration of the heterogeneous sensor and the system diverse in the technology environment constraint and level fidelity is challenging issues not only for the military organization, right? To provide a response to the challenges, right? The concept of Internet of Things is extensively developed worldwide with the focus on civilian application, right? IoT is considered as an integral part of future internet and could be defined as a dynamic global network infrastructure with a self-configuring capabilities based on standards and interoperability communication protocol, where physical and the virtual things have identity, physical attributes and the virtual personality and use intelligent interface and are seamlessly integrated into the information network, right? The concept which is developed for the IoT for the civilian market does not fit into the military requirement, right? Highly dynamic and disruptive environment, fragile nature of the wireless communication, especially at the lower tactic level, specific requirement for the speed and the fidelity with the which information must be exchanged and analyzed requires robust and effective mechanism as well as the specific application that present an IoT solution does not provide, right? The Internet of Military Things refer to the network of sensors, wearables and other devices that use cloud and edge computing to give advantage to the fighting forces, right? Long-term evolution, LTE is standard for the wireless broadband communication for mobile devices that increases the capacity and the speed of the data transfer and provide several add-on facilities, right? The Internet of Military Things is a type of Internet of Things designed for combat operation and warframe based upon a smart technology and artificial intelligence, right? It comprises a complex network of interconnected entities in the military domain that continuously communicate with each other to accomplish that broad range of activity is more efficient and informed manually, right? So there are the several protocols which is developed for the Internet of Things for the civilian market which is not fit for the military requirement, right? So to fulfill that military requirement, we need a higher data speed and all kind of requirement is for the military. For the military requirement, we need a faster data transfer and a very secured way, right? So for that, the several protocols are developed and that are still in under maintenance and construction, right? So that's about a military of things, right? After that, let's see the home automation with an IoT, right? So that is a basic application of an IoT, right? The home automation is an automatic control of an electronic device in your home, right? These devices are connected to the internet, which allows them to be controlled remotely, right? With the help of the, any application or any particular triggering things, right? We can control that things with the, we can control that things on our fingertips, right? Interconnected device unable to intelligently monitor and control smart homes in the future Internet of Things, right? Energy saving application, for an example, control indoor climate and electricity usage by employing context information to switch off appliances, for an example, light, computer, fans and all that things, right? Reduce room temperature, close windows or stop warm water circulations, right? So whenever someone is coming into the room, right, so at that time the light will be turning on when it is dark, right? And when someone is leaving that room, that turn on all the appliances will be turning off by itself, right? So that is an one example of how you can use the Internet of Things in the home automation. You can control each and every item of your electronic appliance with the help of an IoT, right? So from the Wi-Fi to the mobile devices, turn all kind of things, the turning on and off light, the controlling the AC temperature, right? So the weather controls conditions, all the things we can handle with the help of the IoT, right? With the help of the sensor, we can sense its surrounding, right? And with the help of that sense data, we can process that data and take appropriate action, right? And with the help of the actuators, right, we can do several tasks, right? Such as if you are entering into the parking, right, its parking door will be open automatically, right? When you are nearer to your window or nearer to your door, right, so that door will be open itself. It is, there is a hotter environment outside, right, then AC will be turning on or setting by itself, right? So that is the example of the smart homes and kind of thing, right? The home automation works on a three levels, right? Monitoring, control and the automation, right? The first one is in monitoring, right? So what do you mean by the monitoring, right? Monitoring means that the user can check on that devices remotely through the app. That, for an example, someone can view their live feed from the smart security camera, right? The second thing is in control, right? Control means that the user can control that device remotely, like planning a security camera to see more of the living spaces. The third one is an automation, right? Finally, the automation means the setting of the device to trigger one another, right? Like having a smart siren to go off whenever the armed security camera detects in motion and kind of thing, right? Right? So the home automation works in the three levels, right? After that, the smart lighting, right? The smart control of the lights with the automation signal system to save the energy, right? Smart connected lighting is the next generation energy efficient LED product with the additional sensor to sense the thing such as occupancy and the temperature, right? So with the help of that, we can turning off and turning on the light, right? After that, we can control its brightness and all kind of thing. In an automatic light control system, a light dependent resistor LDR sensor is used to detect light, medium, dim and the dark condition, right? And with the help of that data, we can handle that light, right? It is a simple enough to envision the addition of the sensors communication to create that initial concept of the smarter, more adaptive lighting, right? If people are present, turn the light on. If not, then turn them off, right? Or the use of the smartphone to connect to the lighting system and tune it to the desired brightness level or the particular color, right? Amazon lights are there, right? The smart lighting is considered one of the main solution for the energy reduction, by meaning that controlling lighting level according to the desired need with the minimum energy consumption, right? Smart lighting system utilize the motion and the lighting sensor for performing that control algorithm, right? So that about that smart lighting. The system uses the motion and the light sensor for detecting the surrounding environment. There are lamps, control with a specific lighting level in order to supply the adequate in order to supply an amount of lighting required without affecting the user visibility. Certainly, the requirement lighting level is strongly dependent on the weather condition. In clear weather at the right in clear weather at night might require more luminance than the cloudy one, right, due to the reflection from the clouds, right, while during the mist and the foggy weather, right, require the highest possible lighting level as the visibility reaches its lowest. On the snowy weather, it might be required to intermediate level between the clear and the foggy, and the during the night it requires the high lighting level, right. During the night it requires a high lighting level, while at the day it needs just a faint level to provide an guidance or the turn off it if the weather is clear, right. The lighting concentration in the yard is affected by the above condition, right. So by that you can control your light, right, with the help of that data you can control your light. By that kind of data, you can control that light by your own, or else that particular IoT device will control that light by its own. Let's see the another example of the IoT, the voice apps on the IoT, right? So you all have heard the Amazon Alexa and kind of thing, right? So there will be three type of the voice communication in the IoT environment. The first one is in bi-directional voice communication, monodirectional voice communication, and the voice recognition, right? So there are the three kind of thing. The reason that voice is suited to range of the IoT application. First one is that speech is a natural mode of the communication for the human, right? We all are speaking in our native language or in our natural language, right? So speaking is a natural mode of the communication for us. It is both intuitive and easier to convey command verbally, right, rather than typing or giving by its own. Voice recognition is particularly appealing when the human's hand of the eyes are otherwise occupied, right. Voice telephony is an efficient means of the bi-directional voice communication with the machine that can listen and respond without need of the complex command. Cost saving factor, right. The voice integration could be potentially challenge the need for a touch screen or many devices, as reduce the cost for the device that will be dormant for the majority of the time. The IoT market is broad and encompass a range of consumer, commercial, and the industrial application where voice can play a role, right. There are the significant difference between the drivers for implementing the voice into the consumer product and from those that drive the same technology in the consumer market, right. So voice is the feature that does not need to make any consideration for infrastructure other than the need for an internet connection, right. The voice is a feature that do not need to make any consideration for infrastructure other than the need for an internet connection. The consumer application for the voice includes the virtual assistant for the smartphone as well as the device that do not include integration telephony function, such as wearable device with a minimal screen real estate, right. The device in this category include the smartwatches and the fitness wearables that can offer hands-free voice activation of the multitude of the function through to the smart television and game consoles, right. Game consoles, right. So Alexa is a really nice example for the voice apps over the IoT, right. So let's see the Alexa voice services, AWS integration for an AWS IoT, the Amazon Web Services, right. So Alexa voice services, AWS integration for an Amazon Web Services IoT is a new feature that cost effectively brings Alexa voice to any connected device without incurring messaging costs, right. AWS for the AWS IoT has a component, right, that components are a set of reserved MQTT topics to transfer audio message between the Alexa enabled device and the AWS. The Alexa voice services, right, a virtual Alexa enables device, the virtual Alexa enabled device in a cloud that shifts tasks related to the media retrieval, audio decoding, audio mixing, and state management from that physical device to the virtual device, right. a set of API that support receiving and the sending message over the reserved topic, interfacing with the device microphone and the speaker, and managing device state, right? So that's how you can integrate that Alexa voice services with the AWS IoT, right? So that's all about today's session. Thank you for the watching.